Begin by finding a good posture, having an upright spine, relaxed body, allowing our chairs and the floor to take our weight, to receive us to whatever degree we can, telling our bodies that we can trust the ground, trust the earth, and seeing if just anywhere we're holding tension can let go in it a bit. Setting aside any goal, any expectation, any hope, any fear. I hope my meditation is like this, or I'm scared that this is going to happen. Setting all of that aside, acknowledging the great not knowing, each moment being fresh and new. If you have a particular area you want to focus on, say your breath or a mantra or sights or sounds, that's fine. But I'll invite us, if you want to follow along, to focus on our bodies. Notice whatever is most alive in our body and just let that be. If it's the same area, the same sensation coming online each moment, then that's fine. If you notice different sensations, different feelings, then follow that. And notice if we're subtly feeling a sensation, but actually witnessing it from far away, and see if you can come closer to it, closing the gap, bringing your awareness to bear on whatever is most alive, physically actually putting your attention there. And if that feels too terrifying or too difficult, then just be with the area that's resistant and allow that to be. And of course, if you notice any joy, happiness, peace, then allow yourself to soak that in fully. Allow that to be your experience. You can be creative and playful. Notice how you're relating to your experience in your body. If you want, try approaching it from different angles. Notice if you're holding it or relating to it in certain way that's creating tension, and try a different approach. And again, if it feels good, then allowing yourself to take it in more, try to just fully receive it. Either case, both experiences are just fine. Setting aside any goal, any hope or fear, any demand of what's supposed to happen, but having an attitude of curiosity, openness, acceptance, courage, and vulnerability. Again, reminding yourself how you feel isn't the most important factor right now, but how you're responding. Noticing if there's different ways of seeing, different ways of relating, different ways of perceiving that create different experiences. Is there a different way to respond to this experience that brings you closer to being here right now? you notice any self-judgment, criticism, self-hatred or ill will, then try to relax. Don't worry about things so much. Come back to ease. If you notice flowing, peace, joy, happiness, and try to spread that for your whole body so that your whole body and beyond feels that joy and peace. If you feel sleepy or tired, try to be more curious. Use your thinking to investigate, to come closer to the alive sensation. Again, each moment being fresh and new, each moment a new opportunity to experiment with what's the appropriate way, what's the best way to respond right now. Allow this experience to be a dance, dancing with life, dancing with your experience, fully receiving this experience, being here with that experience, sometimes maybe leading, trying different things out, trying to feel in different ways, relax or focus in different ways, and sometimes just fully following, allowing the experience to fully enter our awareness and lead us where it wants. You can trust there's an inner wisdom that knows the right response. You don't always need to figure it out or know what to do, but just allowing our body, allowing our awareness, allowing our breath sometimes to take over and respond before we know what it'll do. And other times we might actually actively engage and explore and experiment with different things. In either case, constantly letting go of any hope or fear of what the experience is supposed to be, and continually trying to see what's the right way to respond.